I've been working from home as a data analyst since before it's been a thing. It's been about 10 years since I've had a dedicated work setup, and in that time I've tried different monitors, desks, a Windows versus a Mac, and today I'll be going over my minimal desk setup that has really increased my productivity as a data analyst. Stay until the end as I'll be going over the one change that has significantly improved my productivity. Back in 2014, I was setting up my first work from home setup, and I wasn't really thinking about ergonomics as I was in my 20s. So I bought this really narrow writer's desk, and it was terrible because my wrists were coming off the edge of the desk. I could barely fit a 17-inch screen. By the end of the day, my back hurt, my posture suffered, as well as my productivity. I really didn't get as much done as I knew I could. Since then, I've made a lot of improvements in my work from home setup. What I use now is two 27-inch monitors, and that allows me to really be able to see all my applications at once. The monitors I'm using currently aren't anything fancy, it's not 4K, but I do find it really practical because the 27 inches is the perfect medium of not being too overwhelming while also being able to see your work on both screens. On my 17-inch monitor, all my data analysis really took twice as long. When I was working on Excel and working with large data sets, I was constantly having to scroll back and forth, and I could barely do any side-by-side comparisons of data. I really like these monitors because they're also really ergonomic. They come with an adjustable height so that I can make sure the monitors are at eye level and I'm not hunching over, because a data analyst is a desk job. So you want to make sure that if you're going to be sitting for long periods of time, you're not looking down all day. Typically, I have SQL open on one screen with the requirements on the other, and then I'll have my email and any messages on my laptop screen. And I find that having two 27-inch monitors allows me to do side-by-side comparisons of code, be able to look at the code while I'm building the dashboard, and it has really improved my productivity and the quality of my work. Underneath my desk, I also added a cable management system because it allows my desk to be not messy with all these cables, which allows my mind to feel less messy as well. I feel like when my space is clean, I'm better able to focus and get work done. Personally, I'm the type that doesn't like clutter. You'll find me always putting things back where they were, like the cushions on the couch. And I just like having an organized space because that allows me to function and be clear throughout the day. This is my first time using a cable management system, and I find that it's really great. I would recommend it to everyone because it's just practical. You can vacuum under your desk without having to move the cables, and it allows your space to look really minimal and clean and less distracted when you're doing your data analysis work. For my laptop, I've used both a Windows and Mac. The Windows does integrate more seamlessly with the Microsoft ecosystem of SQL Server, Power BI, and Excel, but I feel that the technology is now moving over to the cloud and the operating system really doesn't matter as much anymore. As a beginner data analyst, I learned a lot of my skill sets using a Windows. But now as a data analyst in tech, most of us are using a Mac. So when people ask which operating system should you use when you're learning data analysis, my answer is that it really doesn't matter that much anymore. I was initially using the Dell XPS laptop when I was learning data science and practicing data analysis skills, and that laptop was very powerful and worked fine for me. And recently I moved over to the M2 MacBook Air, and I have to say I really love it. It does integrate really well just with the Apple ecosystem, but also works great just as a powerful laptop that's not as expensive as the MacBook Pro. I use this laptop personally for data analysis as well as for my YouTube work. And please like and subscribe if you are enjoying this video, as it really does support the channel. And regardless of what laptop I'm using, I always make sure that I use a VPN for security. I want to give NordVPN a huge thank you for sponsoring this video. As a data analyst, one of the best perks is that you can work remotely. But that also means public Wi-Fi, which is very risky when you're working with private sensitive data. NordVPN is one of the best ways to protect your everyday work as well as your personal browsing. They're offering 4 months free when you buy a 2-year plan using my link below, which is nordvpn.com/agatha. A feature that I really like is the MeshNet feature, which allows me to securely send files between my phone and my laptop. This is great because it has increased my productivity as well as being able to share data files securely between my devices. You can sign up at nordvpn.com/agatha and the link is in the description. Now for the chair. I have to admit the chair is a splurge. I bought the Herman Miller sale chair and it has been a game changer. I actually loved it so much that I bought my mom one and she also loves it. What I like about it is that it has adjustable arms, especially being someone who's not very tall. I like that I can adjust it to my height as well as the back support. I actually have a lot of back pain from sitting all day and this chair has helped me significantly with it. And I pair it with a foot cushion which allows me to sit upright and at the right level at my desk. One of the best ways for me to stay focused as a data analyst is by listening to lo-fi music. It really makes the work way more enjoyable, and when I'm querying data or building dashboards, I can listen to the music and kind of tune everything out and remove all the distractions. I'm using the AirPod Pros and they have a noise cancellation feature that allows me to remove all distractions. These come particularly in handy when I am working in the office because people will be on phone calls all day and just being able to zone out and just focus on my work has really made me productive as a data analyst. I'm using the Apple Magic Keyboard with a numeric keypad and I find that the keypad makes a huge difference because as a data analyst, I'm doing quick calculations or I need to input some numbers and that really makes me work faster. As well as the wireless function of it really keeps my space nice and clean. As for the mouse, I'm using the Apple Magic Trackpad. I have to say when I first got it, I was on the fence because I didn't know if I really liked all the features and I preferred a traditional mouse. But having used it, I do really like that you can customize it and open applications quickly. So I have to say I've converted and do enjoy using this mouse. Now the one change I've made that has made a huge impact on my desk setup productivity is my desk. And not only is it just a desk, but I have to say the depth of your desk will make a huge difference because you want it to be at least 30 inches long so that you have enough room for your wrists on top of the desk as well as being an arm's distance away from your monitors. The desk I'm using now is a 30 by 60 inch desk. I find that it's actually the perfect size that it's not overwhelming and I can fit my monitors as well as my laptop and just have enough elbow room to spread out. I do really wish I had a standing desk because I find myself standing a lot at work. But if you don't have the opportunity or if you're picking between a bigger desk or a standing desk, I would say choose a bigger desk because that's what's most important. On top of my desk, I like to keep it really simple and minimal, and I would highly recommend that you have a dedicated workspace for your work at home because laying on the couch, laying on the bed, you'll fall asleep, and that is the worst way to stay productive because I've been there. And if you are interested in learning more about productivity and how to self-study, then I'll link this video, and thanks so much. I'll see you there.